So the BattleTech box sets are out. I mean, we have been waiting a long time for this, not only since the announcement date of it, the release date of it, of course, being delayed, and the idea of the previous box set, which was amazing, gave you a ton of mechs, gave you the hex maps, gave you the rules, gave you the narrative, but it was in print for a little while, and then it was just gone, and you couldn't get it. So for those of us who enjoy BattleTech, having the chance to have a starter set, especially if you're a completionist, but to have a starter set to begin to get people into the hobby was very, very welcomed for that. And I hope this set, these two sets, the Beginner Box and the Game of Armored Combat, the second level box, I'm really hoping they'll stay in print for a while. I know as of this podcast right now, there's some delays, there's some shortages, a new reprint is on the way with it. I'm hoping it'll keep things going because a proper box set for BattleTech is key, not only in the rules, but also in the mechs. And before we kind of look at the summary of the box sets to get your opinion on it, my challenge in presenting BattleTech or my challenge in pulling in a new player isn't so much the rules. I mean, certainly the rules are very nuanced with BattleTech and there's a lot of depth and a lot of tactical decisions out there. It's a great rule set. Years ago, I think it was a little more challenging because if you didn't have someone to introduce it to you, you kind of had to fumble through the rules. Now you pop on YouTube on there and you kind of see the rules and you watch the rules. You still got to work through a couple of games, but it is a lot more approachable. So in a box set, having approachable rules certainly is important, but in this day and age of the internet, I don't think it's as critical. As long as things are laid out that they can follow. The challenge with BattleTech compared to other wargaming systems is, and we're not even going to get into Total Warfare yet, we're just looking at mechs, the sheer number of mechs that are out there. When you approach this hobby, you're like, where do I even begin to buy mechs? Like, what do I even start with? Now, are they that expensive? You know, $8 to $10 a pop? Out there, I mean, I think in terms of other wargaming systems, BattleTech is reasonable, especially since those mechs you can use with different factions and mix and match. So it's not like, say, something like Warhammer 40,000, you go all in on Space Marines and then you decide you want to play Eldar. That's a completely different selection that's out there. So BattleTech is somewhat reasonable to approach, but what mechs do you buy? And what's interesting is in a lot of war games, the system, sci-fi war games, you know, historical is something completely different because you're limited by the history. Sci-fi war games, when you create your factions, you tend to create three tiers of units, stuff that's really, really good, stuff that's okay, and stuff that's average. You know, so like your rank and file troops, your somewhat fast attacked stuff, and then, you know, your really, really elite, powerful things on there. And they have points, and they have matches and values. You get into BattleTech, and you realize that, and I'm not trying to, like, beat on anyone's sacred mech. Some of these mechs are awful. You read the technical manuals, and you see some of these mechs where the design is intentionally junk because all they're going to do is just have to sell lots and lots of these mechs. Or in the narrative, like the Vulcan, where you've gotten the narrative massive rebellion, and they need to put down these rebellions with mechs, city fighting, city tech, urban combat. So they invent the Vulcan, or you invent the urban mech, you know, as a corporation, and you sell them, and you sell the spare parts, and you sell the service contract. So if you take an urban mech or a Vulcan outside of a very, very, very narrow set of parameters on the tabletop, you get punked, you get blown apart. There's some mechs that are just absolute junk with flaws in there. Now you can get into customization and things like that. But that is a little bit challenging to approach where you have to explain to some people, look, some of these mechs are intentionally gimped on there. And you kind of got to learn your way. Oh, and here's, you know, like 70 different mechs to pick from, dozens of tanks, dozens of support vehicles. And you're like, what do I even do? Now, if you're part of a BattleTech group or you're with a couple of players, you're hanging out playing with me, you've got a lot of mechs you could try out. A lot of different things you can experiment with. It's a little bit more approachable. In the box set, what I was hoping for, and they did this with the Game of Armored Combat, and the starter beginner box, all the mechs in there are pretty solid. There are no junk mechs in there. You take those mechs, you play those mechs, you're learning about pure energy mechs, you're learning about mix and match ammo mechs, you've got some really light mechs that are scout only, you've got assault mechs, you've got medium mechs. I mean, the medium mechs are great selection. There's a lot of real, all the mechs are amazing in the set there, not only with how they look, but their role on the table. You purchase that box set, those mechs alone will not only teach you the game, but they are a solid addition to starting your collection, to the point where a lot of gaming sets, like with 40K, you go in with a friend, Warhammer 40,000, you go in with a friend, and you know what, I'll take the Chaos guys, you take the Imperium guys. You know, we'll split the cost. We'll split the miniatures on there. Great way to get in at an affordable price. I wouldn't split anything with the Armored Combat set. Everything in there is really, really good. So I was really pleased to see that. And I was really pleased to see, I like the old sculpts. I like how a lot of that history looks, but that they refreshed them and kind of updated them a little bit, that makes it that much more approachable. So I think absolutely fantastic. Now, the real question is the jump-in point. You've got the Battletech Beginner's Box, two mechs, one map, really stripped-down rules. And it's like 20, 25 bucks. 10 bucks a mech, you know, and plus some narrative and plus some rules and an attractive box. You buy it, you play it once or twice. If it doesn't work, no big deal. You give the mechs to your kid and they'll play with it or whatever. The Game of Armored Combat has more mechs, has the full rules, has the narrative on there. That goes for what? I've seen it anywhere from $40 to $80. And we've got a lot of price fluctuations right now because of reprint issues and stock issues. I mean, the demand for it has been massive. Both are interesting. But what I would have liked to have seen in the beginner box was the full rules. I would have liked them to have, you can have the starter, little starter stripped down rules, but I'd really like them to see them put out the regular rules in there and skip that completely. Because I think combined with the internet and combined with other players, it is a lot more approachable. I mean, it's almost like they think it's still like 1995 on there and the internet doesn't exist. Maybe I'm wrong with that. And maybe it's easy for me to say that because I understand Battletech. And it's easier for me to approach that. I wish that beginner box had the full rules. I think that could have some transitioning problems moving in. I was pleased to see the Alpha Strike stuff. I'm hoping that Catalyst will continue to support Alpha Strike. I know the current Lance packs are all pretty much sold out and done. So you've got to kind of homebrew your Alpha Strike cards and things like that. I prefer Classic. It's hard to say Classic. My mind, there is only one Battletech. I prefer to play Classic Battletech, but I also like Alpha Strike because A, it allows you to diversify your miniatures and play them in a different format. And I also like Alpha Strike as we have 30 minutes to play. Let's play some Battletech, right? You're playing some other game. I'm playing 40K or I'm at the Board Gaming Club and we finish up. We got 30 minutes left. Not really quite ready to go home. We're not playing a 4,000 battle value or 6,000 battle value game of Battletech, but throw down a map, throw down some mechs, play some Alpha Strike, blow some stuff up. It allows not so much an alternate way into Battletech, but another way to experience Battletech. So I'm hoping that Catalyst will continue to push and support through there. Your thoughts, especially for those of you who have been playing, I jumped into Battletech with the Battletech main box, the City Tech, and the Aero Tech, those kind of three sets with the cardboard miniatures on the front and on the back, and you had the little house symbols, and you kind of put them in the stand to know who's who. I think this is the best set, and I think it does in many ways top the previous set, even though you got less mechs, you know, inflation, it's what it is, but there isn't a single bad mech in either one of the new starter sets on there.